Okay, to answer that question, first of all, let's have a nice little breath in. So we'll breathe in, and then we'll breathe out. We do that every single day of our lives. We kind of do it without thinking. We're bringing air in from our planet's atmosphere, bringing it into our lungs where there's loads of fine tissues that pull the oxygen from out of the air and send it traveling around our body in our bloodstream. Now, fish are slightly different. Instead of like going, all they can do is just go, like forever, just breathe in. They breathe that water in through their mouth and flush it out through these gills, these sort of exit slits, if you like, at the back of their throat. The water comes in full of oxygen, it travels through the gills where there's fine tissues that pull the oxygen out of the water and then travels outwards. So genuinely fish, they're just constantly using their mouth to sort of suck the water in through their face. Some fish use sort of gill flaps, so in other words their cheeks are kind of wide and they can use those cheeks to flush water extra fast through the gills to get added oxygen. But a lot of fish can't do that. A great example, of course, is the great white shark, which has to swim forwards for its whole life. It has to have water going in through its mouth to oxygenate its body, else it's game over. Game over for the shark, but for the little fish the shark is chasing, well, I guess they get to breathe a bit more easily.